his house and we ordered takeout. Just took a shower. Face is all red. Anyways. And I actually worked out here and I drank most of my post-workout smoothie. And we had to rush over here so I didn't get a chance to film. But for dinner, we ordered takeout from the Italian place. Not over here, it's near our Airbnb. I just got a spaghetti bolognese. And I did want to add some fried noodles. So I added some fried noodles to my order here. I don't think it's vegetarian. It looks like chicken's in here. Mm. And his mom, did she bake this?
No one baked this.
Oh, one of his brothers baked some cola cake. So, I have some tiramisu in the fridge, so I'll be having that for dessert as well. Hey everyone, it's Monday. And I'm still at his house. We're actually gonna stay here for the rest of our time. And right now we are heading out to do a bank run because I'm running out of money. And also go to DM to pick up a cleanser. And oh my God, I need to write things down. I think it was just a cleanser, but I don't remember. So this is the fifth look that I came up with using the Marvicorn palette. And it's just like it's like a daytime smoky eye. I can never get my eyeshadows to look as dark as other people's. But I have, I think two shadows or three shadows on my lid. I mean, as the whole thing. And then the orangey color here is from my Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette. So that's my look for today that I'm only gonna sport for like an hour or so. And I'm gonna put my hair up because last night I did not rinse my hair. I'm really tired. We're both pretty sick and I think there's so much heat in here that I'm burning up again. Yeah, so we didn't do anything today. Today was supposed to be going to another city, but I just couldn't move today. So tomorrow we'll try going to the castle and then Wednesday is his birthday. So I don't know what's gonna happen, to be honest, but we're gonna try to do as much as we can. We have very little time left. Oh, and very little time to get to the bank, so, okay. We're back at our Airbnb. We actually got here an hour ago or something, and we plan to just pack like a little bit since we have a couple more days or several more days until we have to move out. And guess what we did? We actually packed up probably 90% of our stuff, which is funny because 90% of the stuff was from the kitchen. And we still have a lot of things to pack and to throw away, like especially their recycle stuff. Oh my God, we're actually clearing out. It just feels so crazy because I don't know, we've done a lot, but at the same time, not really. So it feels like we just got here, but also feels like we've been here for like a really long time. We'll eventually be out of here in the next couple days. I have to film a video here because I have all these beauty products that I want to talk about. I've been wanting to do this for like 2 weeks, but never got to it. Oh, and did I ever show you this is my filming setup? I have to use these boxes as a tripod and then stack them on top of this baby chair and then like film in front of the window. It's ridiculous. Like, I can't even film in this house either. And then we have this whole bedroom to go, which is just our suitcases and stuff. So this is not as bad as the kitchen. I'm kind of glad to be moving out of here though. Wasn't exactly the most pleasant experience, but it was an experience nonetheless. Yeah, so we'll be back tomorrow. Okay, he's not gonna like me for recording, but is all our stuff. Okay, all our stuff that we just transported over. Oh my God. I said to him before when we got here, like, can you believe this isn't even all of it? Because we just brought over non-perishable things and then we brought over whatever we could just grab really easily. So we're packing up his already pretty packed room, but of course we're planning to clean up the place and stuff, but it's just absolutely ridiculous. I'm gonna send a picture to my mom. Yeah, she's gonna freak out. But then again, it's like not that much. Maybe it is a lot for two people. I don't know. We're overachievers over here. I just wanted to do a little haul. We went to the same stores as we always do, DM and Etika. At DM, I bought this Balea shower oil. That's what it's called. I couldn't for the life of me remember what this was called. I was telling him that I need a body shower, body wash with oil, but that's like different. There are body washes with oil, but I was looking for a shower oil. So anyways, they have, I think they had three of them, and this is the store brand one. They have, Dove has one, and Nivea has a shower oil, but I don't know. I was just looking at all the ingredients, and I kind of wish I researched ingredients and if they're good or not for your skin and, you know, just stuff like that. But I just decided to go with the store brand one. I normally like to think that Dove stuff is really, but I haven't used Dove products in a really long time, ever since I switched over to like natural body care. Their natural brand actually didn't have a shower oil at all, so I was pretty surprised. But anyway, so I got this one, and it says it has 70% oils in there, which was the highest number of oils compared to the other two, so I just decided to go with that one. I'm gonna actually try it tonight, so hopefully that works. And then I got this natural cream cleanser. I want him to use a gentle cleanser because I made him get the Neutrogena pink grapefruit one, and that's super drying for my skin. So especially during the winter, I don't want him to use that when I leave. So I just decided that we should just try this one. It's super small and it was almost $5. So I won't say it's worth it because it's just a cleanser, but I'm gonna try this tonight and I'll let you know. This one is the Essence, the gel nail polish. They have a whole range of nail polishes, and this is the first time I've ever seen Essence. So went with the one, okay, there's no name on it, but it's this lilac color. Super pale, really like it, it's so cute. I should stop buying nail polishes, but oh well. And then also from Essence, I got the Make Me Brow. And I follow Essence on Instagram, and they asked everybody who follows them what their favorite Essence product is, and a lot of people said Make Me Brow. They also mentioned Lash Princess, but when I went there, I completely forgot which one of the Lash Princess mascaras they like, because there's one with like volume, and then there's like a false lash effect one or something like that, and I don't remember. I think most people were saying the one in the blue tube, but those two were in like black tubes, and then the volume one was like in pink writing or something, and then the false lash one was in blue writing. So I wasn't sure if that was the blue tube or whatever, but anyway, so I decided to get the Make Me Brow because I've been wanting something that could fill in my brows without my having to actually fill them in, but I don't think that's gonna happen because I don't really have brow hairs, especially on this tail. And also because I need something to kind of tame my brows. They're not seriously bushy, but they can get out of hand sometimes. I just hate that whenever there's drugstore brow product, they only have like two shades, and it's like taupe and brown. My eyebrows are lighter obviously than my hair color, but I still like, I don't know, Asher's kind of toward gray black. They only have two shades, and this is the darkest one in Brownie Brows. This is the one I got in Etika. They didn't have this at DM, so I guess it was more on the pricey side. This is the Dove Dermaspa Intensive, whatever that word is in German, but it's a body oil with shimmer in there. Honestly, I just buy things because I don't see them at home. It's messed up because I'm spending money on things I don't need, but I figure it would be really nice to have for the summer, which is not even anywhere near. I have something that I'm gonna use in the shower tonight. I googled this morning or last night that if it's okay to use moisturizer on back acne. Apparently for bacne or just body acne in general, you should use a body wash that contains salicylic acid in there. Yeah, I think you can do it daily too. I'm not too sure. I totally forgot. But just be careful because it can dry out your acne and probably, like, possibly make it even worse. So I think one of the articles or something I read said that you can put a moisturizer on afterward. And there is this other one that said that you can use a salicylic acid wash once a week and compare that with like a loofah or whatever, and then wash the loofah, because loofahs are pretty much like the worst things you can use for your body because they harbor so much bacteria. I think I'm gonna do that. And I think somebody also asked if they can use their salicylic acid face wash. I am gonna try using this because I actually did try using this, I forgot when, sometime last year, and it did dry out my skin. It didn't dry out my acne, I don't think, but it definitely dried out my skin and I didn't like it. So I think I'm just gonna use this once a week. I'll try it today, and then I'm gonna use it with my exfoliating little mitt here with my wonky friend. But I got this from DM, and it feels really gentle actually, but basically anytime you rub your face is like, it feels like physical exfoliation. So I don't know, I'm just gonna do that, and then I'm gonna put my vanna cream on my chest and my back, and I'll just see what happens, because my acne has been really bad, really 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 bad, even though I've been taking the multivitamins that I showed sometime last year. I don't know, my acne's been really bad, and it's most likely because of my sleeping patterns. Like, I still just, I don't know, I just can't sleep right. Like right now it's like 11 or something, and we still have to have like eat a little bit of dinner and shower and stuff. So I'll take a shower now and I'll let you know how all these products work and feel. Okay, so I finished with my shower and I'm feeling pretty. I used the shower oil and that was actually really nice. I was telling Julian before that I actually have no idea what the hell shower oils do, because you wash them off, but I think like as they go on your skin and whatever, like your skin does really feel soft. So that was fine, and I'm really glad that it didn't irritate my skin, because I don't know, like I mentioned having used the Jergens wet skin moisturizer or something in the shower when I went to Universal, like when I came back from Universal in July, and that completely wrecked my legs. Like I was just itchy all over for days after I started using that. And then I use the cleanser. Okay, let me tell you about the cleanser. There is a very strong lemon scent because it's such a natural product, and I think it just didn't occur to me that when natural products have a lemon scent, it can potentially irritate your eyes, and it definitely stung. So I don't think I'm gonna use that cleanser in the shower anymore, because I like to use my Foreo with my cleansers at night. So yeah, I'm not gonna use that at night. So I'm just gonna use that exclusively for the mornings. Such a waste. And then I use the Neutrogena grapefruit body wash, face wash, with my exfoliating mitt thing. I showed him and before, I think, but that's actually a lot gentler on my skin than I thought. I think when I first saw it in the store, I thought it had like this gritty feel. Not like the exfoliating gloves, but more like if you know like the Japanese brand or whatever, exfoliating towels or something. Like kind of that texture. But oh, it's actually a lot gentler than I thought. But it paired really nicely with the cleanser on my chest and back, and then I also used it for the body oil and everything. It just felt really nice. What I really like about that is that it actually like stays on your hand as you're moving. Of course I had to switch it to the other hand to try to get the rest of my back, because I can't reach that far and whatever. But that's my update for everything that I use. Right now we are just gonna get some dinner, and his brother was actually nice enough to offer to make spaghetti bolognese, and he actually made that like hours ago, like right before we left to go to the bank and, you know, do our shopping. I like it over here. What they do is like they make a big meal for everybody and then they just leave the food there. So I like, well, of course you have to like heat up the stuff, but I get too lazy and I don't want to do that. So good morning everyone. Well, it's like 2 o'clock now, but I still want to go to the castle. Julian is downstairs trying to get some breakfast for us, and I'm putting on my makeup now, and I just wanted to film my using the Essence Make Me Brow that I picked up yesterday, and I'm a little nervous just because I don't want the tint or whatever to change the color of my brows, but we will see. I'm gonna pull it out. Okay, here's what the wand looks like. It's a tiny little spoolie looking thing, and there are tiny fibers on the spoolie. So I'm assuming this like thickens your brows. Honestly, I'm not really sure if I should be using this on top of brow product. I just needed something that tamed my hairs and maybe even added a little bit of color. Okay, let's just say I don't really think it did that much just because my brows are pretty okay. Not exactly unruly. Let's just say my brows feel really cold and wet. I think my tail is a little bit dark here, but anyways, if you can see here, like my hair is stick up, like they need a trim or something. Actually, no, it's not long enough. It looks okay though. Not bad, not bad. I'll try it on bare brows tomorrow. I mentioned before that I have one more shadow to use in the Marvicorn palette, and it's called Bahamas. It's the purple one over here. And I thought it was blue at first. Like I picked out a blue shirt for today and I figured that I would use the blue eyeshadow. There is no blue eyeshadow in here, it's violet. I'm gonna use it anyway. So on my lid, I have the Honey Boo Boo color, which is the orange color in the middle on the top. And then of course I use Flotter, the transition color here, as my crease color. I'm just gonna put Bahamas on my lower lash line. And I didn't record any of this because I have no setup here, but if you can see it on my lower lash line, I have Bahamas a little bit, just one layer of it, and it actually is really pigmented too, just like all the other shadows in this palette. Yeah, it's just really pigmented. It's a really, really nice purple color, and it's really nice. I think I'm just gonna drag it out. Have like do a wing. Oh my god, he's so cute. He came in here because he smells all of our breakfast stuff, which by the way, it was one Roma tomato and a sandwich. Look at him. Look at him. He's big. And I can't believe he's actually gonna get way bigger than this. A touch. A touch. Yep, he smells it. Salami. Okay, here is my finished makeup look, and we are running late. Oh god. Here I did a wing with the shadow underneath, and then I lined my eyes with purple eyeliner, and then I have the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in Stockholm. I always ask him which lip color looks best with my makeup, and he just picks whatever, and I just wear it. My hair is a freaking mess because I fell asleep with my hair wet, but anyways, it is so sunny today. Well, right now. It's only going to be sunny for an hour. As you know. Yeah, so we're gonna head out to the castle now. Oh, it's dark. Okay, so we're on the bus. You probably can't even hear me because it's really loud. And I have a freaking headache because I was like really warm back at home. And then we went out, obviously, to walk all the way to the bus stop. And it's really cold. And now we're on the bus, which is really hot. So I kind of want to die right now. But the castle is not that far away, I think. And I'll try to get some footage while I'm there. Well, I probably will anyway. But yeah. Buses are really nice. Not loud. Relatively clean. No cameras in here. Very interesting. And the ride is really smooth, just because they have really smooth roads here. Very nice. Still sunny out, which you can hardly see, but it is. Apparently we just missed the bus that takes us to the castle, and we have to wait about 20 minutes, but I'm not gonna lie, the bus ride was very pleasant, and it's really sunny out, which this is the first time, by the way, that I'm wearing my sunglasses while I'm here. Actually, the second time. The first time was when we got picked up from the airport when we landed in Dusseldorf. This is the first real time wearing sunglasses out. Yeah, so 20 minutes of pretty pleasant weather. Considering I'm really warm, this is helping me a lot. But then by the time that bus comes and we get on and I will be in really warm temperature, I'll probably get a headache again. Makeup looks pretty good. Eyebrows fine. Hair is a mess. Look, it's a river. And look at these cute houses over here. And there's so much construction going on right now. But apparently there's like a lift that takes you up to the castle, and I didn't want to take it because I'm scared of heights, and also because I think it's closed.
Yeah,
we're trying to figure out how to how to get there, but yeah, it's pretty nice here. Okay, so we just started our trek up this ridiculously steep path to get to the castle. The lift that takes you up there is closed, so we're gonna have to do this on foot. I'm already out of breath, and we just started walking about 2 minutes ago. But just look at how steep this is. Yeah, I think it gets steeper. And they also tell you that you should have like proper footwear and stuff, but clearly we don't. I have my over-the-knee boots on and he has his sneakers. It's so crazy because I do have Timberlands and he has boots. Not via boots. But yeah, it's so interesting because we have to walk through like a bunch of people's houses and stuff. But look how cute this is. Oktoberfest. Okay, I'm dying. I was just not made to walk in general, but we are high up now. Not that high yet, and this is our view right now. Really nice. Okay, here we go. There's a lot of construction going on, and it's so cute. It's just like one long path, and everything else is like forest. But this is definitely, this isn't the hiking trail, but it's a trail. By the way, we spotted some hens and a big ass rooster. But yeah, so.
Ducks. Right behind
them. Oh. This is where we are. Lot of trail to go left. Finally made it up here. I couldn't even get a shot of like our almost being here because I'm completely out of breath. But oh god, more stairs. Actually, there weren't any stairs, but still, like, oh god, there's stairs here. Okay, there's like nobody here. I see a bank. Oh my god, this is so crazy. But oh my god, I think you can go in here, but I'm not sure. Honestly, yeah, it's like castle stuff, but I feel like there are also people living here. I don't even know.
It looks like it.
But yeah, I guess this is part of the castle. Really nice. Kind of creepy. There isn't like a single soul here, which is really creepy because they don't close until 6, so I'm not really sure where the hell everybody is. But okay. I think like nobody's here. It closes at 6, but nobody's here because it's Tuesday, so there's like literally nobody here, but this is the view.
That's where the lift goes.
Wow. Oh, people are eating in there.
Oh, right. I see this like subway station looking thing, that's where you get to.
Wow. So crazy.
Those guys are looking.
Yeah. That's supposedly the information booth. This is the entrance to the castle, I think. But it's closed.
No, I think there are many entrances.
Oh. Yeah, we haven't gone all the way around yet, so. Yeah. God, it's really nice over here. Super peaceful and quiet. We are back at an Airbnb. I wanted to make, like, a, I don't know, unexpected trip back here. Just because I want to come back here every to pack and get things ready and whatever and transport things. There is actually so much more stuff left. We're packing up our shack packs right now. I got one done here, and actually I have two done, and oh, he has one done too. And I'm gonna just grab some clothes for tomorrow, and then hopefully maybe even like tomorrow, or actually Thursday's our last day, we'll be able to bring all of our stuff, like our suitcases especially, back. But I'm planning to bring as much back as possible right now because I just don't want to keep doing this and it's annoying. I think the most annoying part of transporting things is transporting all this like fridge food. And there's some things that aren't open. Oh, actually, I think these two are the only things that are not open. Like, so I can like take them out and probably like let them sit, even though it's kind of gross. But I don't know how to bring all this back. Our living room. I don't know why. We cleared out so much stuff and there's still stuff. I really don't miss being here though. Like, my feet are freezing. And I think I mentioned not, but he bought a thermometer and he put it in our bedroom because that's the coldest room in this place. And it's 17 degrees, which means that whatever they told us about 18, 19 degrees being the comfortable temperature is a lie. So yeah, needless to say, my feet are just cold. Okay, so back home, and I feel like these days I always look like poops. At the end of the weather sucks. Managed to pack a lot of things. We cleaned up like crazy. His phone died while we were at the Airbnb and I left my phone here, so we couldn't contact his mom to pick us up, but she's not even home anyway. Right now, I'm gonna work out. I spent so much time sitting here on Twitch eating chips and stuff because I'm like starving. We didn't have dinner, we actually just had dessert. So he's making hot dogs right now. I'm gonna go work out first, shower, and then I'll make the rest of my bolognese sauce that I had at the Airbnb. But yeah, this is like all of our stuff now. I basically junked up his room so badly, like it was not anywhere near this bad when I first got here. Hi everyone, it's Wednesday. It is this guy's birthday. And right now I'm trying to do like the most minimal makeup and do it real fast because everybody is waiting downstairs to celebrate. And I like to wait until last minute to get ready a lot because, well, it depends what I'm doing, what I was doing beforehand, and I was cleaning a whole bunch of stuff. So as you can see, there's like clothes all on the bed behind me. Yeah, I'm just gonna try the Essence Make Me Brow and put on a little concealer, a little mascara, and bada bing bada boom. I think that'll be it. So normally when I do like a no makeup makeup look, I go with a shimmery blush, and I'm just using my Deep Throat one by NARS. Sorry, this is like horrible, you're on a suitcase right now. Kind of see a tint, but it's definitely not gonna draw in any brows, brow hairs. I mean, it doesn't look bad though. Pretty interesting that it works like that. I think what really helps is that there are fibers in this brow product. I was looking at the Benefit Give Me Brow or Give Me Brow product for so long, but I just never bought it because I don't have brow hairs for the product to grab onto, so I don't know. Looks pretty okay, but I think I'm still gonna end up filling it in. It's pretty much as I can do. They look okay, not too bad. I don't think I filmed any time after I said we were gonna go to the grocery store. I don't remember, but anyways, I was gonna mention that I actually have been liking the Make Me Brow. If you remember at the beginning of this video, so I put the Make Me Brow thing in first and then I filled in the gaps with my pencil. My brows were freaking bulletproof. Like, I didn't even have to use the Urban Decay Primer Potion on my brows. So interesting. That's just day two, considering I don't have full brows. And the brow product didn't work as well as I wanted it to, I guess. It still pretty much did what it was supposed to do, which was like tint my hairs a little bit and also tame my brows. The thing I didn't expect was for it to keep my color in. Here eating grapes right now. Julian is downstairs making our pizza. We went to the grocery store and bought a lot of groceries for pretty much the next week. It's just so funny because we clean up so much today, but there's still so much stuff left in here. Hello, it is Thursday and I have crazy voluminous hair, more like it's dirty. It's voluminous but dirty. And I wanted to do an eyeshadow look that matched the same shirt that I wore yesterday. And yeah, I'm just being gross. I mean, I didn't go anywhere yesterday. So I actually have quite a few eyeshadows that match my shirt. I don't know why I keep trying these like really, really old duo eyeshadows. I don't know, but I decided to go with the Modern Renaissance palette because it has, let's see, one fresco in here, and that's a very middle shade on the top, and it matches my shirt. I was looking at the Marvicorn palette too to see if I could possibly like mix some of the colors and stuff so I can use both palettes for this look, but I don't know, I decided to just stick with the Modern Renaissance palette, and oh my goodness, let's just say I missed using it, because even though this look took me like an hour plus, I was just sitting here and blending. I completely missed how well it blends. It just looks so buttery. Every single time I do a look with just using these colors from this palette, I mean, my looks just look so seamless. I would say it's beginner friendly. And I used Buon Fresco on the lid, Raw Sienna right here on the bottom for my crease and transition color, and then the Cypress Umber color, the dark brown one right here in the outer corner. It's like I use the same transition and crease shades. I just changed my lid color. I should have just left it as a matte look because I haven't done a completely matte look before, but I decided to just pop a little bit of shimmer on the middle of my lids, and I just used the ColourPop Super Shock eyeshadow in Revolution, and on the inner corners and my highlight for the brow, I used Vermeer, which is the middle shade next to Buon Fresco. I am completely over the moon about this palette. I completely, 100%, absolutely, whatever, recommend that you get this palette if you're interested in fall and like warm tones. And I mean, there are cool shades in there too, but I just feel like it's totally, like, it's the perfect colors for a soft, subtle look. I mean, you can kind of go a little more, but you know what I mean? Like, they're subdued shades, but they pack a really strong punch every time you use them for a look. I'm all glammed up for Burger King again. We are going to Burger King with his friends again to give his friend his birthday gift that didn't come in the mail until like 2 days after we were at his house celebrating his birthday that time. So we're gonna do that. And I think maybe it's kind of like a celebrating Julian's birthday a little bit too. I guess that's the only thing we're gonna do for that. Okay, so I didn't film Burger King, obviously, and going back to our Airbnb, but I definitely want to record whatever is at the Airbnb because I can't believe we actually cleared everything out. And I think it took like three days to clear everything out because we have so much stuff. But yeah, so I wanted to do an update. I don't know what happened to my brows. I probably scratched it by accident, but it's gone. This one is fine, and it was raining. So I think the best way to apply the Essence Make Me Brow product is to apply it first and then fill in the gaps with a pencil. It's kind of annoying for me though to have to use two products to get my brows to stick, because it's a different story if I was filling in my brows and then I used one of those wand brow gels to just keep my brow hairs in place. Like, I understand it's not supposed to keep the pigment on your brows, it's just supposed to tame your brow hairs, but I don't know, for me it's just annoying because I'm always oily. I think if I continue to use that, then I'll just do it first and then my pencil. I'm pretty sure if I do like the primer potion, the then my pencil, and then set everything with my brows, with the make me brow, I would have eyebrows on my face for like, I don't know, for days. But I don't want to have to go through that much trouble. But just to be on the safe side, like, I don't know, I might actually do that. But I don't know, I really like my makeup today. I don't know, the lighting doesn't do it justice. It looks really nice in person. I think on camera it looks okay, but the mauve on my eye isn't picking up at all. It's actually a really nice look. I'm really happy with the way it came out. I'm gonna work out right now. I have a shower cap on my head because I put in a mayonnaise and extra virgin olive oil mix in. Then I think I'm gonna do a scalp detox, which is just adding some salt to your shampoo. And I think, like, preferably you would want to use the pink Himalayan salt, but since I don't have that, I'm just gonna use sea salt. And I think I tried that when I first got here and it was fun. So I'm just gonna do that. My hair has been really gross this week. I'm not really sure what happened. Yeah, and then for my shampoo, I've been liking the oh my god, I can't say this. It's like everybody in America butchers it. Yes, Schloss. Thanks. So I've been liking that shampoo, and I forgot which one it is. I think it's like the vitamin one or something. It isn't a clarifying one, which is not what you want to use when you're detoxing your hair. But my other one is an anti-dandruff shampoo, but I'm not really sure if I want to use that. But it is clear. Maybe I'll use that first and then the other one after that. I don't know, it's kind of like overboard, but I just want to know why my hair is so gross here and see if that helps. So anyways, that's about it. Tomorrow we need to go to our Airbnb at 9:30 and have it inspected or whatever by our hosts, whichever one, to see if they need to charge us or something for something we, I guess, didn't clean or something. Because otherwise they would just charge us a cleaning fee, which is something that we haven't experienced yet, just because like we clean up anyway and then we just go on about our business, and we don't get charged for that. I mean, we pay a cleaning fee like up front, but I mean, I don't know, it's just gonna be so weird having like somebody just look around their place and see if some, like, you messed up somewhere. But whatever, I clean that place like from the door to, I don't know, the farthest place from the door, from end to end. See, there we go, from end to end. Anyways, then after that we're probably just gonna grab some breakfast if we have time, and then we're gonna go to IKEA tomorrow with his mom and his brother. So that's it for today. I can't believe it's been almost an entire week again, and we actually really haven't done anything but having fun here, being tired and stuff. You can see how gigantic my eye bags are.
We're moving out. I'm doing the filming this time because she's extremely tired and also sick. So I will be the one to do the filming this time. And basically I'm just gonna show her around a little bit to show how we left the place. I made sure to leave her home because she would have probably jumped our host's throat for making us get up early. So this is the bathroom. Pretty clean in my opinion. We left everything as we found it. All the towels and bed sheets. That's the hallway. Just my shoes and my bag that I'm gonna take home. One of the pairs of slippers broke, so we replaced it with a very similar one. That's the kitchen. The fridge is empty. Pretty much everything just like we found it. Garbage can. Empty. Oh, we should have put it back in there. Okay, I'll do that. Bedroom. I have to close this. Other than that, we stacked our pillow and blankets. Pull out the sheets. Maybe I could pull up the curtains, I guess. Yeah, that makes sense. living room. Couch, put the blanket on there. That's the couch blanket. Put everything back on the table. And we used to sleep on this couch too, so we just took off the couch sheet and the blankets. Oh, the red blanket belongs into the bedroom. Alright, let's take that. And put it here. That's pretty much it already. I think the entire place is pretty clean, if I may say so myself. We vacuumed like just 2 days ago, I would say. Thing in the world. Tried to straighten out all the carpets. This one here, we had folded, so it has this really nasty crease. Honestly, that should not be a problem. It's still a functional carpet. Other than that, pretty much set to move out. I did spray the bathroom stuff just once. Air freshener, just to make sure that there's a nice smell when they come in here in 50 minutes. Can't wait for a trip to IKEA today, and I hope that I covered everything. Time to pull up the shades and leave. Bye, Lotta. That's the name of this apartment, by the way. A lot of American stuff, by the way. Don't think that's intentional, but very fitting. Bye.
Hey everyone, it's Saturday. I think I may have gotten like a little bit of footage yesterday, but I don't remember. I think so, but only on my phone. Basically, it was like super tiring yesterday. Went to IKEA. I guess I never mentioned anything because yesterday my camera was already on 2 bars. Actually, 2 days ago it was already on 2 bars, and I just didn't think that it would die so quickly, and it did. So by the time we got to IKEA and I turned my camera on, it died. So I couldn't get any footage, which sucked. And I don't really mind recording on my phone, but it obviously isn't the same, so I just decided to leave it. I am hoping that we go back though, because we bought something that he ended up not needing, so I definitely want to return it. Let's just say their IKEA here is amazing. So clean. There's a lot of stuff. It was very big. We went to the one in Dusseldorf. We bought a lot of stuff. So his mom was so nice to drive us there, and his brother also came with us, and he helped us carry our stuff and load things and everything like that. So it was really nice. The food was really good. Yesterday he and his brother built this desk, and it's a simple desk, but it comes with something that you can pull out like this, and it's really nice. It actually pulls out pretty far, but the stool over here is in the way. And actually, you know how like IKEA has like displays and stuff, and they had a drawer here that like you can roll out and stuff, and I think there were 3 drawers in it, but we didn't buy it. I don't know, like I guess he didn't think he needed it, but obviously I did. But that's okay, like we can definitely go pick it up next time if anything. Oh, we bought one of these tables. It's not your typical end table, but it's just big enough for anything that he needs to put on it. We bought this lamp, which is really bright. Obviously it depends on what light bulb you put in there, but it's really nice. It's just super blinding. I'm not really sure if I want to turn it on, but yeah, it's really bright, but I love it, like, because his light in here is super blinding. So imagine just waking up to that. So I figure this one's really nice to have. And then we got another table, which is this one. It's a bigger one. It's actually the medium size, and it has a plank under here. So we're planning on just filling these up, like just putting whatever he needs on it. And the one he already had, we just cleaned it up and everything. So tomorrow we will be tackling like all of this stuff. And I got these, I made him get these dividers and stuff, so he can put them over there. Yeah, so there's still a lot left to do in here, but it's such a freaking mess, especially because I put all my stuff in here. I'm hoping that within the next 2 days we'll pretty much have everything set up and it'll look a lot neater in here. And because like I can't help that I have a lot of bags and like groceries in here, but he can help the way that like all of his stuff is in his room. So I'll see you all next time. Bye. I'm gonna fall for the gravity.